A completely new approach suggests that in reality, in physical reality, it's quite likely that singularities do not exist, and instead all black holes possess something entirely different. A new paper simply titled, "Do Black Holes Have Singularities?" A scientist that has an entire metric named after him, Dr. Roy Kerr, a mathematician from New Zealand who made a lot of intriguing propositions about black holes, answered the question.
Because of the rotation, the inner horizon forms and you don't have to collapse anymore.
Today we are going to discuss one of these explanations proposed by these iconic black hole scientists. Around the time the concept was born a few decades ago. He was actually the first to realize these types of concepts like singularities only apply to black holes that are completely stationary, do not possess any momentum, do not possess any charge, and most importantly, do not spin. These kinds of black holes are called Schwarzschild black hole, and they make sense mathematically, but not physically. That's because all black holes that we have discovered to date usually spins and are also expected to contain charge as well. And so Dr. Kerr proposed the concept of spinning black holes that are now known as the Kerr black hole. From 1916 until 1963, the Schwarzschild metric was the only known solution of the Einsteinian gravitational equations for the field outside a physically realistic source. At first, it was believed that there was a singularity or firestorm around its event horizon. But Eddington and Finkelstein showed that this was false. People's attention then shifted to the possible curvature singularity at the center of Schwarzschild black holes. The question that Kerr asks are pretty complicated. Was this inevitable for real bodies that collapse inside an event horizon? And could it be replaced by a well-behaved non-singular matter distribution? Back in 1970, Stephen Hawking and Roger Penrose proposed the idea of singularity within black holes in a joint paper. You can find the paper in the description below. Simply put, when we talk about singularities in the context of black holes, it means that once you pass the point of no return or the event horizon, you're headed in only one direction. Let's call it down. Even if you try to move left, right, up, you are still essentially going downwards. So, what's down? It's supposed to be the singularity. Let me show you an animation by Andrew Hamilton which illustrates this concept well. In Asians, it represents a point of infinity where everything gets compressed into what you might think as nothingness or somethingness. However, the mathematics involved breaks down, making it unclear what exactly happens at this point. The original idea suggests that everything would be crushed into an infinite something at the singularity. However, many scientists question this because infinity is mostly a mathematical concept and may not exist in physical world. Consequently, not all scientists accept singularity and believe there might be a better explanation yet to be discovered. This brings us to Dr. Kerr's Kerr black holes. Unlike Schwarzschild black holes, which are stationary and lack spin, make sense mathematically but may not be entirely physical, Kerr black holes are spinning black holes. These black holes are more complex, featuring additional regions. One of those intriguing regions is the ergosphere. It represents a peculiar area in space-time where remaining still is impossible. Even if you try not to move, the space-time itself will move faster than the speed of light, forcing you to move. Interestingly, within the ergosphere, objects can gain so much kinetic energy that if they manage to escape, they leave with more energy than they entered. This has led to the idea that ergosphere could potentially function as an infinite engine or a source of free energy, a concept where a significant amount of energy could be extracted from black holes. Importantly, simple circular orbits around these black holes are not possible. Due to the spin of space-time caused by the black hole's rotation, everything experiences a complex orbit. The black hole essentially drags space-time around itself, causing itself to orbit in a spectacular manner. This dynamic leads to the creation of massive torus-like structures around black holes, with various particles orbiting in intricate formations. These particles interact, generate significant frictions, and emit bright light, the kind often observed from black holes. It's crucial to note that simulations depicting a perfect flat disk are not entirely accurate. The prevailing belief today is that almost all discovered black holes, if not all, exhibit spin. This suggests that they are likely Kerr black holes, characterized by rotation rather than simpler non-rotating ones. The visual representation is more likely to resemble a complex spinning structure rather than a flat disk. Let's highlight the main difference between this non-spinning black hole and the spinning one. The non-spinning black hole lacks rotation, while the spinning black hole generates powerful centrifugal forces, significantly altering the overall geometry of space-time around it. This transformation turns it into more of an ellipse than a simple sphere. These centrifugal forces create a distinct ring shape in the middle, a result of the frame dragging effect that distorts the curvature around the black hole, extending to the singularity. Interestingly, if you were to ask different observers around the black hole to point at its center, they would indicate different locations. Unlike a basic Schwarzschild black hole, this type does not annihilate everything in the middle. Some theories even propose that you could theoretically pass through this ring, treating it like a wormhole. However, current mathematics can't precisely explain where it might lead, if anywhere. In practical terms, it would be challenging for a physical object to survive the tidal forces within the ring. Perhaps some subatomic particles might endure, but larger objects like humans? No, we wouldn't. In this recent paper, the argument takes a different approach, focusing on the paths of various light rays entering a black hole. While Roger Penrose and Stephen Hawking previously proposed that this light ends up in the center, creating a singularity, Kerr argues differently. Due to the lack of the black hole's rotation, not all light necessarily converges to the singularity. Kerr's studies introduce the idea that light rays might be tangential to the event horizon, not necessarily having endpoints and potentially remaining inside the black hole indefinitely. Some rays might have endpoints, but they don't have to terminate at the center. This study explores various possibilities, suggesting that not all light rays end up in singularity, contrary to the prior assumptions. His overall conclusion challenges the necessity of singularity in black hole. After 6 decades, Kerr proposes a new perspective that eliminates singularity entirely. Importantly, he combines empirical observations that all black holes spin and possess other properties with his previous idea, often involved in a ring-like singularity. According to Kerr, once you pass the event horizon, it might be possible to move in a different direction within the black hole, as long as you remain between the ring and the event horizon. Leaving the black hole is still impossible. You are confined within the event horizon. However, moving between these regions becomes a conceivable scenario, possibly indefinitely. The key takeaway is that singularity is not mandatory, and entering the event horizon doesn't necessarily mean everything converges to the center. Kerr's argument challenges assumptions made over the last 60 years, highlighting that a perfect classical black hole, as previously envisioned, does not align with the physical reality of black holes. Whenever a black hole forms, whether from a supernova or a massive matter collapse, it inevitably gains some angular momentum, causing it to spin to some extent. The idea of singularities, according to Kerr, is more of a dogma. He supports this with physical examples, using different types of stars. However, the challenge remains that we lack an understanding of what happens inside the event horizon. Solving this puzzle requires a new theory, bridging quantum mechanics and relativistic theories, as Kerr suggests in his paper. Kerr emphasizes that quantum mechanics likely holds the answer, and once we grasp them, the need for singularities will vanish. While infinities and singularities exist in mathematics, they don't seem to have a physical counterpart. The concept of dividing by zero doesn't align with physical reality, This perspective, presented 6 decades after the initial proposition of singularity, adds an intriguing dimension to the black hole science. For those not deeply immersed in black hole science, the relevance might become more apparent if a black hole were found nearby. Extracting energy from rapidly spinning black holes is a possibility, as discussed in a recent paper. If a black hole were to exist within our solar system, it could offer a potential explanation for the elusive dark matter, a topic that we have discussed and will be explored more in future videos. Thanks for watching.